Chapter 4 Metals and Non-Metals Introduction. A substance which cannot be broken down into two or more simpler substances by chemical reactions, by applying heat, light or electricity, is called an element. For example, iron is an element because it cannot be broken down into two or more simpler substances. Some of the common elements are sodium, magnesium, iron, copper, silver, gold, and mercury. Every element is represented by a separate symbol. The smallest particle of an element is called atom. An element is a substance which is made up of only one kind of atoms. Metals and non-metals. On the basis of their properties, all the elements can be divided into two main groups, metals and non-metals. Characteristics of metals. Metals are malleable and ductile elements which are good conductors of heat and electricity. Metals are lustrous or shiny. Metals are usually hard and strong and cannot be cut easily. All metals are solids except mercury, which is a liquid metal. Metals have high melting points and boiling points. Metals have high densities, which means they are heavy. Metals are sonorous, which means that metals make a ringing sound when we strike them with a hard object. Some of the examples of metals are iron, copper, silver, gold. Characteristics of non-metals. Non-metals are the elements which are neither malleable nor ductile. They are brittle. Non-metals do not conduct heat and electricity. Non-metals are not lustrous or shiny. They are dull in appearance. Solid non-metals are usually neither hard nor strong and can be cut easily. Non-metals can be in the form of solid, liquid, or gas at room temperature. Non-metals usually have low melting points and boiling points. Non-metals have low densities, which means they are light. Non-metals are not sonorous, which means non-metals do not make a ringing sound when we strike them with a hard object. Some of the examples of non-metals are carbon, sulfur, phosphorus, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. Metalloids. The elements whose properties are intermediate between those of metals and non-metals are known as metalloids. The examples of metalloids are silicon, germanium, arsenic, and tellurium. Physical properties of metals and non-metals. Malleability. 1. Metals are malleable. The property which allows the metals to be hammered into thin sheets is called malleability. It is due to the property of malleability that metals can be bent to form objects of different shapes by beating them with a hammer. Non-metals are not malleable. Non-metals are brittle. This means that non-metals cannot be beaten into thin sheets with a hammer. Non-metals break into small pieces when hammered. Carbon is a non-metal. Carbon is found in many forms, such as charcoal, coke, graphite, and diamond, etc. The property due to which non-metals break on hammering is called brittleness. Brittleness is a characteristic property of solid non-metals. 2. Ductility. The property which allows the metals to be drawn into wires is called ductility. 1. Metals are ductile. This means that metals can be drawn or stretched into thin wires. Gold and silver are among the best ductile metals. Non-metals are non-ductile. This means that non-metals cannot be drawn into wires. Sulfur and phosphorus are non-metals and they are not ductile. 3. Conductivity. This means that metals allow heat and electricity to pass through them easily. Metals are good conductors of heat and electricity. Copper, silver, gold, and iron metals are good conductors of heat. Silver metal is the best conductor of heat. Non-metals are poor conductors of heat and electricity. This means that non-metals do not allow heat and electricity to pass through them. For example, sulfur is a non-metal which does not conduct heat or electricity. 4. Luster. Metals are lustrous or shiny. This means that metals have a shiny appearance. This is called metallic luster. For example, gold and silver are used for making jewelry because they are bright and shiny. Non-metals are not lustrous, they are dull. For example, sulfur and phosphorus are solid metals which do not have luster. 5. Strength. Metals are usually strong. They have high tensile strength. This means that metals can hold large weights without snapping, without breaking. For example, iron metal in the form of steel is very strong, having a high tensile strength. Sodium and potassium are exceptional metals that are not strong. 2. Non-metals are not strong. They have low tensile strength. This means that non-metals cannot hold large weights. They break easily. For example, graphite is a non-metal which is not strong. 6. Sonorousness. 1. Metals are sonorous. This means that metals make a ringing sound when we strike them. Non-metals are not sonorous. 7. Hardness. 1. Metals are generally hard. This means that most of the metals cannot be cut easily. Sodium and potassium are exceptional metals that are soft and can be cut easily with a knife. Most of the solid non-metals are quite soft. This means that most of the solid non-metals can be cut easily. Only one non-metal, diamond, is very hard.